Hey guys, welcome back to another video. We've got some good news today, and that is Imerge version 6 is now available. If you don't know what Imerge is, it's our photo editing product, and it's come a long way since it was first released in 2018. And this is thanks to you guys for the feature requests and the suggestions that you give us, as well as the developers for implementing that feedback. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new features in version 6, the biggest being brush masks. We'll also be looking at some new effects, including light rays, a multi-point gradient, lens distortion, and a few others. In other good news, our spring sale is starting very soon, so be sure to subscribe to either our social media channels or the email newsletter to be notified when it goes live. Let's take a look at the most exciting feature of version 6, which is brush masks. These brush masks make it much easier to isolate an area of your image or effect. So I've got this picture here, and it's a really nice picture, but what if I wanted to change the time of day? A big factor in the time of day is the way the sky looks. So I have this picture of a sunset, and I want to cut the sky out of this and place it on top of this original image. Now before, you either had to use an area mask, which is a predefined shape, or a vector mask, which means you click and you add in all the different points and you go around. Vector masks are easy to add, but once you try to manipulate them quickly, it gets a bit tricky because you have so many points. So instead, what we can do is come up to masks and then select brush. And now my mouse cursor has changed to a circle. You can change the size of the brush by using your mouse scroll wheel or up here at the top where it says radius. If you want to change the softness, you can hold down shift and use the scroll wheel and you'll see another circle appear. You can also change the opacity of the brush up here up top. Now it's as easy as painting in the areas that you want to keep. So for example, I will go in and I'll paint in the sky here. And if I want to take an area out, I can right click and do that. Or you can change the brush type up here so that it removes an area instead of adds it in. And that's as easy as it gets. If I wanted to decide that I want this cloud in the bottom here removed, I literally just paint it out and it's gone, just like that. I don't have to move a bunch of points. I don't have to create another mask that takes it out. I just paint and that's it. Of course, this isn't the end of the composite. I would add something like a color match background, and then I can select that image and increase the strength and it will start to match the color. I'll also just crush the shadows a bit so that it matches a bit better. But you can see how easy it was to really just paint in the areas that I want. Here's another example of how you can use brush masks on effects. So it doesn't have to be a mask on an image. If I wanted to add the clarity effect to this picture here and then boost it up, it looks good, but the problem is if I go to view and then highlight warnings, you can see that I'm blowing out the details in the sky. And that wasn't happening before I added the clarity effect, so I know that the effect is causing it. What I can do is come over here to this icon and select brush again, similar to last time. And what I'll do is change the invert switch over here. So right now, clarity is affecting the entire image. If I come in with my brush and I just paint around this area here, I can get rid of the effect in that specific spot. And again, I didn't have to draw any sort of points. I didn't have to use predefined shapes. I literally just painted over the area. And it was that easy. So here's without the effect and here's with it. You can see that area of the sky remains the same because it's not being affected by clarity. Now let's take a look at the new light rays effect inside of version 6. I have this image here and I want to increase the feeling of atmosphere, and one way to do that is with light rays. So I can just add that in and then you'll get a little circle here which you can move around, or you can use the center controls in the controls panel. But I'll just place it somewhere that makes sense for this scene. And you have a variety of controls to dial in the way that it looks. So for example, I'll increase the threshold, which means that not so much of the image is getting affected. And then I'll also lower the distance just a little bit so that the light rays don't go as far. I'll change the blend to screen because it's already quite white. I don't want to be adding pixels on top of each other. And then if I wanted to, I could increase the tint, which would give the light rays a specific color. In this case, it doesn't really make sense because it's a black and white picture, but you do have that option if you wanted to do that. But that's how easy it is to add light rays into your image now. It's, you know, drag and drop, place the control, and then adjust the parameters as needed. We have a new effect called lens distortion, which can either add or remove it from your picture. And it's as simple as dragging a slider. So you can see there, it takes more the shape of a pillow, or if you want to go the other way, it'll distort the lens more around the edges than in the center. It also has settings for chromatic aberration and de-vignetting around the edges as well, if you need to bring back some of that lightness. The new multi-point gradient effect is a good way to add multiple colors into a plane or onto your image. You start with 4, and each of them has a control point, so you can move it, you can make it bigger if you want, which increases the spread. If you want to add another color, you just click. The color dialog box will appear, and I'll just choose something like this. And now I have another color inside of the gradient. If you want to change the gradient type, you can change it from points to this other one, which results in a more geometric shape. We've also added a new halftone effect, so if you need to get that newspaper print look, you can do that very quickly. We have a couple presets if you want it to have color or no black at all. That's it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoy the new features. If you'd like to try out version 6 for yourself, you can find a demo on our website. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.